the woman who helped us back at the warehouse. The woman
wearing red. I wish I could join you when you go overseas for your treatment, Katleya. If only I was able to save you from the vampires who kidnapped you.
Katleya, don't think this way. You shouldn't be sad for every life that you can save. You aren't responsible for each and every one of us. Your duty is to kill Supremo, and that's the only thing you should do.
There's a certain young man in your neighborhood. That young man is a part of a very important prophecy. Tristan Torralba, find out everything about his past. This is our chance to strike hard.
If we fail, that's it. Supremo's gonna have our heads.
Their force is gaining strength, and there's one more thing, a female vampire.
Was Boris referring to you, Leah?
Gilbert, I apologize. My car suddenly broke down.
The thing I hate the most is when I'm made to look like a fool.
The car broke down from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m.
That's the time Katleya was rescued. Okay, now.
That vampire is powerful, like Supremo. She has superior strength.
Did you grow up in San Isidro only?
Just there.
What do you remember about your father?
The thing is that you know Tristan. Has anything out
Just
of the ordinary
spark.
Happened? Like what happened with your parents? Because they were destined
but
to be
enemies. But
they
were able to change that.
Between us, who needs the other more?
Are you plotting something to get back at me?
Tristan. We need to know if there's a part of your past that you've forgotten. So just cooperate with me.
We'll be together soon.
Who was that?
Are you dating someone? Or have you had a girlfriend? Everybody loves to hear a good love story, Mr. Imperial. You need a woman in your life.
Is that really necessary?
You do. Unless you aren't into women.
I'm not gay, Jacinta. If you're proposing for me to get a woman, tell me. Can it be you?
No.
Why in the world not? Do you have a boyfriend? Or girlfriend, perhaps?
Are you trying to turn the tables on me?
Or maybe you're still in love with your ex.
In love? No. But had I loved? Yes. The kind of love that hurt me profoundly. It was a forbidden love.
Who was he?
Did you see someone?
I didn't. But I distinctly heard a voice telling me that we would be together very soon.
Who could have possibly reached out to you to tell you that you'd soon be together?
Like what I told you, Mr. Imperial. I was profoundly hurt because of that love. So I'd rather not talk about it. But what about you? I know you're not in a relationship right now. But have you ever loved?
What will you say if I tell you that never in my life have I felt my heart beat for anyone?
Maybe you've never felt it. Because you don't have one at all. Only heartless people have no capacity to love, don't you think? But who knows? Maybe the woman who'll finally make your heart beat is coming.
Theodore, I need you to come here.
I'm in the middle of something.
I need you here now.
You already have Tristan.
We can't let him carry the whole mission. He cannot do this alone.
If you really want me to be there, then so be it.
Good. We have to protect Tristan at all costs.
We had a long night, Mr. Imperial. See you tomorrow. Good night.
Tristan, the lady who arrived just now, who is she?
That's Samantha.
So the vampire's here.
How did you know that?
I heard the other moon chasers talking about her.
Jake, go get some rest. We can manage just fine.
No, I'm staying.
He and Asintha said the exact same story, and about the same time their car broke down, a raiding party suddenly showed up at La Liga Unida and proceeded to rescue Katleya.
And simply because of that, you now believe that she wasn't part of the attack?
Do you honestly think I'd simply believe a mere human, Paglinawan?
But Asintha...
She's making sure that I believe what she told me. Like, it's very important that I do.
I don't want to be rude, Supremo.
I thought you'd be running circles around Leah in her own game. But I have a feeling...
It's the other way around. Supremo, before she plays you for a fool...
I suggest you kill Leah now.
And if she's not Leah, why don't you just turn her into a vampire instead?
Will I ever see you again, Nognog? Boss?
Ning-Ning.
Didn't you tell me one time that Jacinta Magsaysay's parents are based in Manila?
I did.
I want you to look for them.
Yes, boss.
Who are you really, Jacinta Magsaysay?
Miss Jacinta looks awfully familiar.
I just can't remember whether I've already met her before.
Your powers manifested before our eyes when we rescued Katleya. But it is of the utmost importance for us to determine the limitations of your new powers through these tests we've prepared.
Go ahead and try to run, Malia. She can be wounded, but a werewolf's bite doesn't affect her vampire blood at all.
Gael.
She doesn't seem to possess the speed of a vampire. Does this mean that her werewolf lineage is stronger in her?
I still can't pick up any scent, though.
There's only one way to find out. Gael! Do it! Malia! Honey, are you okay?
There's nothing different in her blood.
In that case, training stops here for now, Malia.
Based on what we saw here, Malia, the only power you've manifested so far is your ability to heal fast.
And you aren't affected by the bite of a vampire or werewolf.
We can conclude that you have equal parts vampire and werewolf blood in you. All we can do at this point is give it some time. I'm sure your true power will manifest.
This way, ma'am. There.
Good morning.
Is Tristan Toralba here?
That's me. How did you know that I'm here?
I just wanted to speak with you.
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Mio's. Emilio Alcantara.
Why are you looking for him? What do you need?
I know something about your friend.
Why should I take your word for it?
Because I have vital information about him.
Won't you join me?
I've eaten. I had an early start, so I had time on my hands to reflect about what you've told me. That I have to be relatable. Lighten things up. Watch the gate, guys. What info do you have on him?
Jake?
It's Tristan! Omar just took him!
What? But how?
It looks like he was the vampire's real target all along.
And not Mrs. Magliari.
I know exactly where they're taking him.
It's a bit old-fashioned, but not all candidates will go that far to get the people to relate to them, so... Impressive, Mr. Imperial.
You see, that's the only song I know. I'm glad there's a use for it.
So what's that song about?
Don't you know? It's a Visayan lullaby. Aren't you from the south? Why don't you know?
I was just testing you. I mean, you could have learned that just now. You know, when you had an early start. But now, I should say, even more impressive. You're beginning to listen to me, Mr. Imperial.
Hello?
Yes?
We've just captured Tristan Torralba.
Good. Just keep it for now. I'll attend to it once I get back. Business as usual.
It sounded urgent to me.
I want to clear all my business deals before the campaign period, because I want to focus on it when it starts.
How could you do this? boss!
Get out of here, Malia! This isn't your fight to deal with!
You traitor! You'll have to kill me first!
I paid my debt of gratitude to Noah. I'm not serving your group, but ends there. It's time for me to decide for myself now, Malia.
Tristan.
Thank you, Jake. Good thing you came for me.
He called me right after they took you.
But how did you know that I'd be taken there?
SMV is one of Gilbert Imperial's companies. I deduced they'd be taking you there straight away.
Jake, how's Mrs. Maliari doing?
Nobody stormed into the house, Tristan. You were the target of the vampires.
You knew I was doing something important.
I ordered you to protect him! Now look at what happened!
Samantha, you told me yourself. The Guardian never makes any mistakes. You were told that Tristan is going to die and he will become a vampire. So, it could happen. He may die as a human and be resurrected as a vampire. You don't hold other people's fates in your hands, Samantha. I tried doing that before. I fought hard for the life of my daughter. I relentlessly studied her blood to try to give her a shot at the new life. But what happened? She was killed by a vampire. Was I able to stop it? Go figure.
I am not going to let go of Tristan. He has a very significant role in the prophecy. And there is a reason why he has become the constant companion of the new Chosen One. And if Tristan were to become a vampire, I am not going to allow him to become our enemy. That could very well happen if Supremo manages to take him on his side.
Let's go. We're going home. You can't swim anymore. We're going home. It's getting late. Why won't you listen to me?
Mommy.
Come on, will you stop being stubborn? You don't want to stop? You won't listen to me? I'll smack you if you don't listen. You're getting on my nerves. Why won't you listen? Don't make
stop
me angry.
That.
You don't want to stop? You
I
don't want to
stop
listen?
It already.
Are you okay, ma'am?
Tristan. Welcome back.
Have some coffee.
Oh, thank you.
Here's a cup of coffee.
Thank you. Here.
Betty?
Star!
Are you alone right now? Where are your niece and nephew?
Yes, it's just me. Apple went out with my mother and father. They went to the park. Tristan, on the other hand, is at work.
Yes, I've noticed that. Your nephew isn't here a lot. Where does he work anyway?
Oh, in pest control. You know, his job is a very demanding one. He goes around killing pests.
Tristan is such a hard-working boy, isn't he? You know, I've noticed how close you two are. I'm guessing you know about what he likes, right?
What he likes?
What he likes. His hobbies. Does he like playing basketball? Or does he read, perhaps? Maybe comic books? How about movies? Does he enjoy watching them? Horror films in particular? Maybe those with monsters or vampires?
Honestly, he's all work. If he has any particular likes, I'd say automobiles and spiders.
Does he frequently party? Like go out at night?
No. No, that kid doesn't do night outs. Although oftentimes he comes home very late. Star? Do you need anything from Tristan?
Huh?
You've been asking a lot of questions about Tristan. Do you need anything? Do you see anything about Tristan's fate?
Will you relax? It's nothing, okay?
Come on, Star, tell me. Is something going to happen to him? The last time you came here, you said something unpleasant, and then Tristan didn't come home for several nights after that. So just come out with it, Star. Is this the same thing? Is something going to happen to my nephew? Tell me the truth.
That's the plan I submitted to Prof T.
You are not safe as long as those two are walking about freely, Tristan.
Don't think about me, guys. Supremo is running for president, and if he wins, this country will be ruined.
What other options do we have so we can bring them down?
Let's expose them to the world. Let's reveal Supremo's identity, so countries around the world will unite to kill him.
Hanna, that's too dangerous. We don't want collateral damage.
Besides, we can't challenge them to a war when we don't even know what advantage they have over us.
Maybe there's someone out there who can equal the powers of Supremo.
Yeah, sure. But remember that those monsters fight dirty. And Tristan, they survived the uproar from your video. Maybe they have more dirt we can dig up and use against them.
It's good you got out of there safely. Just think about your friend Mio for one. Remember what happened to his family?
Tony is right. That won't work anymore. Paglinawan is a weasel but strikes back viciously.
We need to come up with a foolproof plan.
They have their eyes on me right now. That's why I came up with this plan, because this can take out Paglinawan and Supremo too.
Okay, fine. You want to hear it? Then I'll give it to you straight, Betty. Does your nephew Tristan have anything to do with vampires?
I already talked to them. I apologize on your behalf. I told them that you're just having a bad day.
Bad day?
Do you want to talk about it? Your violent tendencies, I mean. Acting like that while in the public eye isn't good for a candidate like yourself, so watch out. Now, if that's going to be a problem, you need to deal with that as early as now. Is this about your childhood? There are some studies that say traumatic childhood experiences extend well into adulthood. What happened to you when you were young? Physical abuse? Did you perhaps feel that your parents neglected you? What do you think you're doing?
You. What are you doing?
I just want to know what you're feeling, Mr. Imperial.
Everything. Everything began rushing in. Ever since you came along. Ever since you came back. And you do not have any right to do this to me. Leah.
I know it's dangerous, but if this plan works, we will have concrete evidence against our enemies.
No way. So what? You'll offer yourself as bait again?
Tony, remember, I'm their target. If they see me, they'll surely take the bait. Even Supremo will get dragged in.
There you go again, Tristan. We're doing everything in our power to keep you safe, while you're always rash.
You said it yourself, it's dangerous. What if it doesn't pan out? What happens to your family?
Right back at you. What do you think will happen to our families if Supremo becomes president? What are their lives going to be like if we don't go through with this?
Does Tristan have any connection with vampires, Betty?
Vampires? Of course not.
Yes, there is. You wouldn't be reacting this way if there wasn't. I need to know the reason why Tristan always appears in my dreams and divinations. That's right. Even before you moved to this place, I have already seen Tristan in all of my visions. I tried ignoring it at first, but when I saw him in person, I realized something. My dreams hold a deep significance. This has never happened to me before. This is the very first time I've crossed paths with someone I saw in my vision.
Is something bad going to happen to him?
I did a careful study of Tristan's plan. It's very dangerous. But this is one of the best ways for us to prevent Supremo from fulfilling his plans. So I'm agreeing to it. We are gonna go with Tristan's plan. Tristan, brief them, please.
Star, what is it that you saw? Please tell me. Speak up, Star. What's going to happen?
He will become a vampire. That's why I'm trying to learn more about Tristan's life. I need to figure out how things turned out that way. Betty, I'm going to need your help. You've got to tell me everything that you know. I beg you.
Okay. I'll talk.
Who is this Leah? Is she your ex? Or your enemy?
Stop this nonsense already, Leah!
I don't have any idea what you're talking about. You're insisting that I'm that other person. That Leah. Why? Do I look like her?
Stop pulling my leg, will you? Or I might do something you wouldn't like.
Now it's making sense. I see it now. That's why you've been watching my every move, listening to my every word. You're waiting for me to slip. Because this entire time, you think I'm someone else. Gilbert?
Gilbert. Gilbert? Why don't you just call me by my real name instead? Huh? Say my name! Go ahead, say my real name! You know that name! Santino!
My brother was with the Luna Force.
Luna?
A covert military unit that killed evil vampires and werewolves. Our parents didn't have any idea. I was the only one in our family who knew about his job. Until one day, he brought Rika home with him.
That's Betty, my sister. This is Rika. Our mother and father home right now?
Mother? Father?
Yes?
Tanya's home!
Mother. Father?
Good morning, hello.
This is Rika, my girlfriend, also my colleague at work.
When Tristan came into our lives, our family became very happy. Especially my brother.
Grandpa!
Grandpa! Grandpa! Grandpa! Grandpa! Grandpa!
You should cheer for me.
Come on, Tanya!
To lose.
Hey, here comes the baby.
We all witnessed how much love Tanya and Rika had for each other. A simple life. A complete family. Those were the only things my brother wanted. But one day, everything changed.
Father, what's wrong? Why are you crying?
Come here, son.
Father, why hasn't Mother come home yet?
Your mother loves you very much. But she's gone, my son. Your mother's gone.
What happened to her?
What Tonio told our mother and father was that Rika died in the line of duty. He had her buried right away because her body was mangled beyond recognition from the damage she suffered. But that's not what happened. The truth is... He saw Rika again. She had become a vampire.
Rika. What have they done to you?
But Rika couldn't finish my brother off. That encounter, however, was enough to cripple Tonio for life. Tristan grew up having no idea about vampires and werewolves. Or at least that's what I know. We've heard nothing about Rika since then. Star. I steered Tristan away from all that as best as I could. Even though I knew that he'd seen how a vampire murdered his father. Yet here you are, telling me point blank that my nephew will become a vampire?
Star. What do I have to do to keep that from happening?
Aren't you, Leah? Fight me right here. I know you still have your powers. That's why you haven't aged. That's why you didn't die.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I already killed you. I killed Mateo too. I have destroyed your beloved family. Even though your daughter Malia managed to survive, she doesn't possess any powers. The prophecy has already changed. She can no longer kill me! Are you hiding the girl? Huh? You've got the audacity to face me again. I am just going to kill you like I did before.
The visions I saw aren't complete by any means. Whatever future I may have gleaned isn't guaranteed to happen.
But you told me that Tristan will become a vampire. That means it will happen at one point. Star, I am not going to allow that.
A vision is merely a guide for us humans. Our actual fate still depends on our actions, if we will let it come to fruition. And if Tristan adamantly chooses not to become a vampire, trust me when I say this, Betty, it's not going to happen. Besides, according to you, you no longer have any connection with Tristan's mother. So what possible connection does he have to vampires now?
Why do you have to put your life on the line?
Tony, we've already decided, right? So what you need to do now is get some rest and get ready for your mission.
No. I'm joining your group and that is final. I got your back, remember?
Tristan.
Aunt Betty.
We need to talk.
Fight me, Sentinel!
Where's Grandpa and Grandma?
They're out with Berto.
It's already late.
Where have you been?
I came from work and...
What's your job?
I already told you, didn't I? It's a pest control company.
Are you trying to fool me? I'm going to ask you again. What is your job, young man? I expect nothing but the truth. Still thinking about what you will say? Are you going to lie to me again, Tristan?
Aunt, if you're worried about me... What are you doing? What do you need?
What's this?
Aunt, give me that.
What is this, Tristan? tell me the truth before I lose my patience with you.
That's a werewolf's fang.
Why do you have this?
That's what I use to kill vampires. And I know that this is a lot to take in, but they're real. I've already fought a lot of vampires.
So every single day you leave this house, you're risking your life to go against vampires?
Ant, there's a lot of them out there. They mingle with ordinary humans and victimizing them. Father knew about this. He used to go against them too.
Who told you about that, Tristan?
My companions did. They saw the werewolf's fang hidden inside Father's cane. And they told me only Luna soldiers have that. Ant, that's why Father used to teach me how to fight back then. It's because he wanted me to fight, and that's what I'm doing now.
That is not true.
I'm just carrying on Father's duty of protecting the people from those evil vampires, Ant.
No way. Tonya wouldn't have wanted that for you. He would not have put you in that kind of danger.
But Ant,
no, Annie. Tristan! Your father turned his back on being a Luna because it was the best way to protect you!
See me in my vampire form. You are a Asintha Maxeysai. You're my political strategist. And this is just me. Gilbert Imperial.